in the middle of his hangout of Hazel, good chance this is the last one. Park. If not, there's more to come. Yes, I did. The autopsy report.
Bingo. The autopsy report confirms that the cause.
This is a continuation.
Special toxin. The testament indicates that Shiroyama used his position as a forensic expert to mix the toxin into the cold medicine taken by the deceased. But is that really the truth? Is it not possible that the toxin was mixed into the fish liver paste? Well, according to the toxicology report, this white powder only dissolves in water. Neither rice nor the fish liver paste could be used as a carrier of the toxin. The cold medicine was the only option. Putting the poison elsewhere would not only fail to guarantee a lethal dose, but would also increase the chance of it being noticed by the deceased. Therefore, the means is also confirmed.
Add that to the motive for the crime and... So the murderer really was Shiroyama.
Yep.
No, Jack Sherlock.
What you said? Look, I really don't know what Sango is so suspicious about.
Yeah, it's pretty clear cut. Huh. You could say it's almost too clear cut.
Wait, I still have some questions. Based on the fish and red point Kyuji Sawara from Ryuji and Shiroyama, like, the two commit the same crime. Why are their punishments different?
Very nice. Top marks for attention to detail. It doesn't have any real bearing on the case. Let me explain how that works for you. So, why would Madame Kyuji Sawara sign one conviction, sentencing Ryuji to temporary incarceration awaiting trial? Another conviction sentencing Shiroyama to death. You may have heard some rumors back at the station that when this case first came up, the Kujo clan higher-ups were in dire need of a scapegoat to keep the Takatsukasa clan off their backs. And poor Ryuji became the successful candidate.
Hey, my grandma being ill again.
Less than a week, the conviction was drafted, sent to Madame Kujo Sara, and signed. Allegedly, she knew what it was about as soon as she saw it, and signed it with no questions asked. But anyone who buys this story clearly doesn't know that much about Madame Kujo Sawara. She's the most principled person in the entire Tenryo Commission, for goodness sake. So, how would she respond to a case filled with unanswered questions and no confession from the suspect?
Oh, you mean...
Exactly. Before she signed it, she changed Ryuji's conviction from the death sentence to temporary incarceration. Ryuji escaped a disastrous fate without ever realizing it. Had Madame Kujo Sara not changed his sentence, Sango would have been seeking justice for a dead man.
Why was Sara so lenient with Ryuji?
That's the wrong question. This wasn't about Ryuji, but Madame Kujo Sara's principles. The conviction could have been for Ryuji, Guji, even a Tanuki, and she would have made the same decision. Given the enormous pressure she was under at the time, I'd say she did the best she could. Don't you think?
Pressure? Really? Was someone higher up putting pressure on Sara?
The pressure came from all sides. The deceased was the leader of the police station and the rising star of the Takatsukasa clan. All eyes were on this case. How this became reduced to the unimaginative rumor that Madame Kujo Sara convicted Ryuji under pressure from her superiors, I have no idea.
Ugh. Rumors here, conspiracy theories there. Oh, lies at every turn.
Fortunately, Madame Kujo Sara works in an open and transparent manner and pays no heed to rumors like this. She just rolls her eyes and forgets all about them.
How do you know that? How do you?
Just because she has never publicly clarified the truth doesn't mean she was hiding anything. So when I asked her about it, saying it was relevant to a case I was working on, she just told me how it was. Believe me, in this case, more than any other, I have checked every last detail.
Oh, there's more. Why is the research log of the office further in seem blank? Did someone tear out some pages?
This also puzzles me. Mm-hmm. Maybe someone doesn't want us being privy to the contents inside. Or maybe she already tore a bunch of pages out by accident. But regardless, this isn't essential to the case. Like I said before, a lot of what comes up in an investigation is irrelevant information. The crucial elements are Shiroyama's motive and needs, which we have established.
No, that was short. The Stock Authority report mentioned that this poison ain't sold anywhere in Inazuma, but Siri Yomi testimony said it was bought in an international trade association.
Maybe the report was wrong. The International Trade Association is a gathering place for merchants from all over. Countless merchants pass through the port of Rito every day. It's natural for there to be a couple of missing records here and there. Well, I've answered all your lingering questions, and you've checked all the material the police station has. So, what do you think? Case closed.
We have seen everything that the police station has. Now I see the problem.
I don't follow.
At the detective agency, you said, Sango, I have disclosed everything the police station has on the case. When we start to look at the fires, you said to us, everything laid out here is all that the police station has about the case. Just now, you said again, you have checked all the material the police station has.
Huh, great! Why do you keep emphasizing police station every single time?
You tell me. Why do I keep emphasizing police station every time?
Because you're trying to hint that there is other information that the police station doesn't have.
So we're finally here, huh? I was starting to think our investigation was about to end a little early. That would have been a real shame. And alive, you finally saw through my little game. You're absolutely right. There is other information that the police station doesn't have. Reason being, it's my own evidence. And this evidence should help answer a couple of your questions more clearly. Why was the research log from the Office of Forensic Science blank? And where did the white powder come from?
Aha! Paimon knew you were keeping secrets!
Don't you have secrets too?
No, definitely not.
Let's talk somewhere else.
Like you ate the cookie from the cookie jar? Paimon? Oh, I guess I got the hidden achievement. Let's find a quiet place. Alright. Here. But sadly, I had to cut here because the phone is running low because this took way too long. But first, time to check out the achievement. Merriman of the Heart. An ideal detective I am, correctly analyze the motive and the truth behind the crime the first time. Nice. So, once the phone is charged, I see you back in the next part. See you all then.